I'd like to read to you from Elie Wiesel's Nobel lecture, Hope, Despair, and Memory, delivered on December 11th, 1986 in Oslo. Ane ma amin, I believe. I believe in the coming of the Messiah. I believe in the hope for a future, just as I believe in the irresistible power of memory. A Hasidic legend tells us that the great rabbi Israel Baal Shem Tov, master of the good name, also known as the best, undertook an urgent and perilous mission. He wanted to hasten the coming of the Messiah. The Jewish people, all humanity, was suffering too much, beset by too many evils. They had to be saved, and swiftly. For having tried to meddle with history, the best was punished. He was banished, along with his faithful servant, to a distant island. In despair, the servant implored his master to exercise his mysterious powers in order to bring them both home. Impossible, the best replied. My powers, my mystical powers, have been taken from me. Then please, say a prayer, recite a litany, make a miracle. Impossible, the master replied. I have forgotten everything. And so they both fell to weeping. Suddenly the master had turned to his servant and asked, my friend, remind me of a prayer, any prayer. If only I could, said the servant, I too have forgotten everything. Everything? Absolutely everything? Everything, said the servant. Except what? Except the alphabet? At that, the best cried out joyfully, then what are you waiting for? Begin reciting the alphabet, and I shall repeat after you. And together, the two exiled men began to recite, at first in whispers, and then more loudly, the Hebrew equivalent to the ABCs. Aleph, Beth, Gimel, and over again, Aleph, Beth, Gimel, and each time more vigorously, more fervently, until the best ultimately regained his memory and thus his powers. I love this story, for I love stories, but I especially love this one, for it illustrates the messianic exhortation and expectation which remains my own. It also illustrates the importance of friendship to man's ability to transcend his condition. I love it most of all because it emphasizes the mystical power of memory. Without memory, our existence would be barren and opaque, like a prison cell into which no light penetrates, like a tomb which rejects the living. Memory served and saved the best. And if anything can, it is memory that will save humanity. Remembering is a noble and necessary act. The call of memory, the call to memory, reaches us from the very dawn of history. There may be times when we are powerless to prevent injustice. And there never must be a time when we fail to protest. The Talmud tells us that by saving a single human being, man can save the world. Mankind needs to remember more than ever. Mankind needs peace more than ever. For our entire planet is in danger of total destruction. A destruction only man can provoke, only man can prevent. Mankind must remember that peace is not God's gift to his creatures. It is a gift, our gift, to each other.